Well, hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. Today I'm in a pine forest, very close to the place I make my dark forest video. And today, as you have seen, I have lightweight gear with me. I only have my water, a haversack, a little belt kit, and that's all. Some knives, of course. So I'm going to make a little hike out here and of course have something to drink. And beside that, many of you have asked me about my Petromax lantern, how I made that change from a pressure lamp to an ordinary oil lamp. And I made a little video that explained that. I didn't make a tutorial because, well, there's many reasons for that, but when I'm working on such a project, it's very difficult for me to think about recording at the same time. But I'll make a video where I show you in some details what I made and how I made it. And I hope you like that. And because many of you don't have interest in these things, I'll put this video in the end of this video. So when you watch this, you can watch the other one too, if you like. Today is a wonderful day. You can see the sun is shining and I'm in a beautiful forest again. And I'm glad you joined me and hope you like. So hang on. Well, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video from the pine forests. It's a very nice place to be, quiet and no people at all. And some of you have noticed I've got a new tunica from Grimfrost's. This one is a little bit bigger, so it fits me nicely, and I think it's very nice. And I also saw in this video and my previous video, I made a new belt for my belt kits, and it's also made in old school way, so it fits very nicely to this tunica. But remember, in the end of this video, I'll put the one where I have customized my Petromax lantern. So if you're interested in that, watch the last one of this video. And I hope you have a nice holiday, despite the situation we all are in. I hope you can enjoy it and together with your families or people you love. So, see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care. Yeah, and first I dismounted the Petromax lantern, and this is the items that I have removed from the lantern now. This one and this one is going down. in the canister where the kerosene is, or the oil. And I'll show you in a minute how I deal with that problem. This one is the burner up the upside, and this one is actually the one that is attached down in the canister, and that's the big problem. Not to get this off, because it's only a screw, but well, I'll tell you in a minute. Yeah. And here you can see this, and over here this one, I had to close them with two bolts. This one I screwed down and just removed the head, and this one I have kept the head on.
Well,
the biggest problem was this one that was going down in this canister, I think it's called, because this is the thing that holds it when you lift it, so that the whole lamp is going. And you have to remove this, because this one is attached to that one up here. So in order to do that, well, first of all, I had to drill a big hole in this one. And that was not easy at all, because this one is attached to a screw on this, but there's also an iron bar that's going inside this canister, and this iron bar you have to remove too, because you have to have a hole, approximately a hole that big, inside here. Let me see if I can draw it to you so you can understand what I'm meaning. This is the canister where the liquid is in, and I drilled the hole there, and this one, something I'm going to tell you a little bit about later. But inside here I had a tube that I had down in the hole, and this part that was it's very tight here, but I sealed it with some soldering, I think it's called, the thing you're using when you are electric, working with electricity. So there's no gap down here. And this strangler is the one that is here. And the reason for that is I can screw this off, this one, so I can put the other thing that I bought. I'll tell you a bit about that in a minute. But I have to remove the bottom of this.
Yeah.
And this one is actually sitting inside this one. But in order to make it fit, I had to make something. So I had some aluminium that I bended so it fits this one nicely, and then I could mount it inside this. And this is screw I have screwed in through this and this one, and down here I used these. I'm not quite sure what they're called, but I used these to secure it down to the canister. And up here, there you can see, it's one a thing I have bought so you can make your old oil lamps. And it's perfect for this. I secured it with some wire so it doesn't pop up. The only big problem I had with this was the one that you are adjusting the fire width. It was not long enough. It doesn't come out of this hole. So in order to do that, I make this little notch in it, and I made this little tool. So when I put it in here like this, I can adjust it. And I made a little hook here for it, so it hangs there. It doesn't get lost. So, well, it wasn't a easy project, but I think the result was as I had wanted it. and I think it's working very well. It doesn't make any noise anymore, and of course the flame is not as bright as in the old one, but it's bright enough for me, and I can easily use it out in my camp, as you saw in my video. So this one, a burner from Tranquilla. Remove this now. And in here, you drill a hole and put this one down with the wick down in this. And this one, cut off the bottom. Remove the bottom, and mount it there inside this one with some kind of customizing so it fits nicely. I don't know if I have explained it well enough, so you can go ahead. Remember that inside here, this is the Tranquilla, and up here is the burner. But inside here, I have a tube here made of brass, so that the wick goes down. Here, I think I draw it for you. Just a minute. So this is the where the wick is coming up, and here the regulator, and inside here there's the wick going all the way down here, down where there's oil. And because this little tube, there will be no leaks, even if I tilt it a little bit, because up here there's a little gap. I can't avoid that, but it's very high and not so big a gap. So this one is adjusted for this one, so it fits nicely. Well, I hope you understand. For this one, I put a link where I bought mine. It's Danish. I don't know if they are selling, but you have an idea of what I have bought. So, good luck. I hope you can find out to make your Petromax lantern to an ordinary oil lamp if you want to. And must say, I won't be responsible for any damage or accidents that you are having with your new old oil lamp. This is only made for me, and I can only say that it is good for me. You must decide if it's safe for you to use. I've done all I can to make it as safe as I think it shall be. So, but take care and use it with caution. Hope you like. These screws, and they have attached down here and up here, makes it possible to lift it without any danger of it's falling apart. So these are very important. I made four of these all the way around, so I'm pretty sure that this is a stable one that I can use.